Hello everybody, welcome back. Today I'm going to be discussing this book right here, Crisis on Infinite Earths by Marv Wolfman and George Perez. This book was written in 1985 to 1986 with a span of 12 issues. It was somewhat of a conclusion to the DC Universe up to that point, really reset things back to a new status quo. I just happened to read this book for the first time recently, and it was a very interesting read. So today I'll be showing you what it's like by going through some of the pages and giving some of my thoughts on this truly influential book that would go on to inspire and influence dozens of others, hundreds of other comics over the coming years and decades. So let's open it up and just flip through the first few pages. So obviously there, this book features some beautiful artwork from George Perez, who is really a master of his trade. Obviously he and Marv Wolfman together had been writing the New Teen Titans for some years up to this point, and George Perez would go on to write Wonder Woman, reset her after this book. Now the story itself is about really these two beings, the Monitor and the Anti-Monitor. And as you can see there, there's the Monitor. Really, both of them were born out of the creation of the multiverse, which is quite a key point throughout the comic. It features quite a lot of new characters in this particular comic, which you might think is strange for a crossover, but I think really allows it to stand on its own rather than being dependent on all the ongoing series. As you can see there, there's Harbinger and Pariah and the Monitor. And the world really is in peril throughout the story, as the multiverse is coming to an end, all thanks to the anti-matter that's running its ray through the multiverse. All thanks to the man known as the Anti-Monitor, who himself is trying to end the multiverse so he can allow his dark universe to run its way through the world, through all of time, become the dominant and really the only universe. So right there are the Owens. Here's kind of the backstory of the origin of the multiverse, as shown in Green Lantern number 40, as you can see. So would I recommend this to people to read? Well, I think it is an incredibly important book, at least if you're interested in kind of the entire history and story of the DC Universe. While the story itself isn't anything too groundbreaking, it was incredibly new and fresh at the time, and obviously it's gone on to completely change the way DC Comics run things, with numerous crises happening since then, including the likes of Infinite Crisis, Final Crisis, as you can see there, Darkseid, very important to some of those later events. Here's the Spectre, in all his glory, a very important character to these earlier comics one we've understood. It is a very text-heavy book, if that's something you've got a problem with, just because, I guess a lot of the comics in this era were like that, but, yeah, it's something to keep in mind if you're going to read it. But definitely, if you're a fan of this kind of golden to bronze age of superheroes, I think this is an essential read, because you'll see all of the heroes you've come to love in really a very dangerous and difficult situation. One which is really interesting to see how they get out of. And yeah, I think if you're just into DC history or DC lore in general, then it's definitely an important read as well. So that would be my recommendation. And I think that's just about it. So make sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more reviews of other comics and manga. I'll be sure to put them out in the future if I get an opportunity. But for now, I would highly recommend going out and reading A Crisis on Infinite Earths. See you all later.